She lights up the room.
She's 100 miles a minute, I mean, unless she's sleeping.
She really doesn't let anything stop her.
Besides my wife, she's the strongest person I know.
My husband actually noticed that the right side of her body was not moving.
She was, you know, moving, but she wasn't moving.
They came to us and they told us she suffered a stroke.
David collapsed to the floor screaming. Dana was convulsed in hysteria.
We were just floored. We didn't know how this could happen, why this happened, and even for the doctors it was hard to explain.
That was the worst moment of my life.
Dylan was born on normal delivery. She was, you know, developing normally up until the age of about 2.5. She had surgery, and when she woke up from the OR, she presented with weakness throughout her right side.
Just a blood clot had traveled, you know, from somewhere in her body, through her heart, and up to the brain. The hardest part is when she was kind of out of it, laying there, when she's still hooked up to all the tubes. And they told us with a stroke, the next 72 hours would be critical. We weren't sure if there would be swelling, if she would need neurosurgery. All the doctors from all the different specialties came and helped and looked at her. They said, you know, with brain injury, it can be so different for each person. And we were just so scared.
Within hours of finding that out, we immediately, you know, got out of that hospital and went somewhere where we knew she would get the best care possible.
I remember meeting another mom, and she said, oh, I've been to Children's Specialized many times with my daughter. You know, we've been in and out, and the place is magical. It's wonderful. You're going to be in the best hands there.
So she came here for stroke rehab. She was extremely weak on her right side as a result of her stroke on the left side.
She wasn't able to crawl or to walk. She had impaired balance. She couldn't stand by herself.
Basically, we have to make a treatment plan, which included a physical therapist, occupational therapist, and speech therapist.
She wanted to move so much, and you know, I think that's one of the greatest things about pediatric rehab is that kids want to play, they want to move, and they want to do things, and that was something that she had from the beginning.
She jumped right in, PT, OT, speech therapy.
She adjusted quite well, so they were able to maximize her therapy time.
The therapy here brought her quite a long way from where she was.
I never thought she'd be able to dress herself. Yesterday morning, I put out her clothes. She put every piece on by herself and said, ta-da, I'm done.
She came to me, she's like, did you see what she's doing? I said, yes. I was like, but I don't want to make like a big deal about it.
It makes me burst with pride. I honestly went into her school when I dropped the girls off, and I think I told every person I saw that she dressed herself because I was just so happy.
My mom actually asked me if coming here would make us, you know, feel sad. I said, why? I don't feel sad here at all. This is where she's getting better.
We try to do everything that we can to make it as comfortable and playful as possible. Every patient has, you know, different interests and different goals, and we try to incorporate that into all of our treatment sessions.
We're impressed with Children's Hospital from beginning to now.
In a sense, now it's a miracle, obviously, the Children's Miracle Network, and the miracles happen here. And
the facility here is incredible. I mean, the fact that they have pool therapy, they have shower facilities, the staff is wonderful, they're very understanding.
It's also become important to our family to spread the word about Children's Specialized in our community. Let other people know what a great place it is and that it's available if you should ever need it.